And Nigeria's gross domestic product GDP is maintaining a steady rise. The government had predicted that the GDP would grow to 2% in 2018, but the actual growth capped at 1.92%. TV360's Adeshewa Odusoga has been finding out the factors responsible for this growth. Take a listen.
The diversification of the Nigeria's economy seems to be having a positive impact on the gross domestic product. This is evident in the agricultural sector as it survives amid security challenges, giving rise to food insecurity across the country. Financial analyst Gabriel Dahosa speaks on how diversification has affected the country's economy positively.
Essentially, we are looking at agriculture. Agriculture survived the threats from security. A couple of states that were not producing during the height of the issues in the Northeast started producing. So agriculture picked up generally in the Northeast. Also in the Niger Delta, the amount of agriculture that happens there also picked up because there was also peace in the Niger Delta. So generally you saw agriculture picked up. Then you also saw oil and gas picking up a bit.
It's the season of elections and the government is likely to experience a handing over. For the present government had projected a 3.01% increase for the 2019 gross domestic product. Idahosa gives hint on how the incoming government will achieve this projection.
Essentially, most of what we need to do at all levels, both the local government, the state government, the federal, most of them have to do with opening up space for private sector to thrive. There are things like access to land, access to title documents that takes quite long. There are things like permits, getting a permit to build a factory. So those basic ease of business things that needs to be done. If the government really drives the current effort to open them up so that businesses spend less money and less time getting the permits and licenses they need, you will find the economy growing. It's not so much the government investing in some money. It's a matter of opening up the space.
The international oil price has been experiencing a long and steady decline. The big question is how the country will survive amidst this crisis.
The way the market is working, there's some hope that with the effort of OPEC to hold the prices at a certain level, and of course, the fact that Europe and the American economy are not growing very fast to create additional demand. So the demand pressure on the market is not very high. So even with the sanctions on Iraq and Iran, particularly on Iran and Turkey and some other countries by the United States, the price has remained fairly stable because the supply-demand situation has been moderated by Saudi Arabia and Russia, who are the major exporters, who are trying to cut price when the cut production. When the price seems to be going too low, they have managed to cut production to ensure the price remains in that band of 60 plus or minus a few percentage. So it is likely that that price will be sustained this year and Nigeria will just about get the amount of foreign currency earnings that it's currently getting.
The continuous decline of the global oil prices poses a major risk to the federal government economic projections for 2019. This may cause the federal government to begin a review for a new oil price benchmark for the 2019 budget. Adeshewa Odusoga, TV360, Nigeria.